Tell us a little bit about the history of Bandai Entertainment and how you came to be involved with the company. Like, what role did you play in production?
Well, it's kind of a long story, but back in 1989, I was working at the media division at Bandai. And that time, we wanted to release Japanese animation in the US in the form of video. And we did test release with the Gunbuster in cooperation with the Books Nippon, and we released under the label called US Renditions. That went very well, so we next step was to establish office in America. So I was working toward that, and then unfortunately, company made us stop the project. So I decided to, you know, moving by myself. So we formed a company called LA Hero, and I moved to LA, and then they started releasing lots of Japanese animation. Then, when I started, you know, I could acquire the license with very reasonable condition because there was no competitor. Then all of a sudden, people start asking me lots of money. So I couldn't continue, so I sold LA Hero to Manga Entertainment, then back to Bandai, and then, you know, like we discussed and we formed a Bandai Entertainment in 1986. Oh, no, I'm sorry, 1996. And also, I'm sorry. And my role in the production is basically localization. Then back then, you know, pretty much everything was released in the subtitle only. So I wanted to release, you know, with the English dub. So I tried, you know, casting and everything. And actually at the beginning, I kind of tried the Japanese way, that I didn't know how people record ADR in the US, which was completely different from how we do in Japan. So there was lots of challenges, but you know, that was kind of a role that I had in production.
How did the US release of Gundam come about? Was it difficult to convince Japan to bring this program to the US?
Yes, it was very difficult, and it actually took more than 10 years of negotiation with Sunrise. You know, I was asking the license, you know, since maybe like a long time ago. Then luckily, back in 1994, Bandai purchased the majority stock of Sunrise. So they become, you know, a group company. And then we started a discussion in how to, you know, bring a Gundam to outside of Japan. But since then, it's actually took long, you know, it's meeting all the time. And people keep changing, you know, from Japan, and took a long time.
When was it decided that Gundam Wing would be coming to the US?
Immediately when we saw, you know, Cartoon Network launched Toonami in 1997. And they ran the show Sailor Moon and Dragon Ball Z in 98. That time when we released, you know, first Gundam movie on the VHS, we had a plan to bring some Gundam TV franchise to US and also Bandai America to launch plastic model kits business at the same time. So Bandai America wanted to release Gundam Wing because it got the 5 pilot. So whereas the Sunrise wanted us to start with the first Gundam, so there was some, you know, negotiation, but you know, they pretty much agreed. And I think back in 98, the plan to bring a Gundam Wing was ongoing.
Was it always planned to go to Toonami?
Yes, actually, not necessarily the Toonami, but Toonami was you know, our first candidate. We felt that would be the perfect place. And then we quickly flew to Atlanta to meet, you know, Toonami producers, and they, you know, become friends actually, you know. And then, you know, they actually wanted to bring a Gundam too, so negotiation went very smooth.
How was it working with Cartoon Network?
That was great, you know, because we had some problem, which was a censorship that Toonami back then was, you know, time slot in the evening, weekday. And then, so it's basically, you know, kids block. And Gundam was very difficult, I mean, violent, and then bloods, and then, so we have to edit it out heavily. Then, you know, like they had a plan to, you know, they proposed to run uncut at the midnight. You know, we really liked their idea, and then so we could have Gundam Wing aired twice a day, started in 2000.
Did you have any idea how popular or successful Gundam Wing would be?
Well, actually, we are very surprised, but actually, we are hoping because we saw the phenomena toward Dragon Ball Z and Sailor Moon, prior to Gundam Wing.
What was it like working on such a popular show?
I was very excited because for a long time people are talking about Gundam, how Gundam to be introduced, because Sunrise kept Gundam as like a secret, whereas like in America, like Macross had already very popular under the name of Robotech, but no one knew the Gundam, and then we could make good recognition with Gundam franchise with the Gundam Wing.
Did that popularity of Gundam Wing create any problems?
Well, it's as I said, at the beginning, how to edit, to place on the kids block was kind of problem, which actually, later on, there was the same discussion all the time that, maybe Gundam is not for the kid,
Are you surprised that Gundam Wing is still popular today?
very surprised, yeah.
All right. What is your favorite memory from working on Gundam Wing?
One of the good memory I have is the we did a promotion called Win to be a test pilot, which like people join the promotion, and if the winner can actually fly the fighting plane and actually fight do the dogfight with other plane. And I could get I could fight with a contest winner, and that was very much fun.
Do you have a favorite Gundam pilot, favorite Gundam, and which Gundam series do you like the best?
That's actually a very tough question. However, maybe like Gundam Wing is the my first major Gundam project, so I would say Gundam Wing is my favorite Gundam series, as well as the Mobile Suits is also Gundam Wing. I mean, Endless Worlds version.
Wing Zero.
Wing Zero. And Hiro Yui, yeah.
And do you have any other messages for the fans?
Well, Gundam Universe is expanding, and there are so many new projects undergoing. So, please enjoy, and please look, check it up. Whatever the new Gundam's coming. And also, there are always new plastic model kits. So please enjoy the Gundam world. Enjoy that Blu-ray disc for Gundam Wing. Thank you.